Hey guys, what's up? Don Moya of Swapmoto Live here. So unless you've been like living in a cave for the last couple years, you've undoubtedly seen and heard the little familiar buzz of these Stacyc stability cycles. So the Stacyc is actually the brainchild of a motorcycle industry guy, Ryan Ragland. When I first met him, he was a mechanic at factory KTM. And lo and behold, he had this great idea, created this bike that's got a little electric motor and a throttle. In my opinion, it's gonna change the face of our sport, motocross, forever, because it's gonna get kids on a powered, throttled, two-wheel vehicle sooner. The next step is obviously a little mini dirt bike. So, man, all the motocross pro guys, Ryan Villapoto, Justin Brayton, all their kids ride these things. So it's definitely a gateway vehicle to dirt biking. And yeah, I think there's a reason they're so popular. Anyway, anytime you create a new category that's so popular like that, there's bound to be other people joining the party, right? So SSR is another manufacturer of a electric stability bike, and it's real similar. They both come in 16 and 12 inch versions. The SSR is a little more affordable, less expensive, the price tag's smaller. So hey, in true motocross fashion, we're gonna have a little shootout here and see how they stack up. Is it worth investing in the name brand originator, or can you get the same bang for your buck for a little bit less? We have a little test panel of little kids. We're gonna have a good time here at Blackmore Ranch today, so check it out. First, we'll start with the basics of the larger 16-inch model. Both bikes have adjustable seat heights that start at 17 inches, 150 watt motors, and 30 to 60 minute run times. The most glaring difference we noticed between the two from the get-go was in weight. The Stacyc tips the scales at 20 pounds, while the Sprinter is 25% heavier at 25 pounds. In the hands of a 7-year-old, 5 pounds is a lot more weight to handle. And let's not forget about the moms, who have to unload and load them from the back of a vehicle. Aesthetically, both bikes have their hits. The Sprinter has a more motorcycle-oriented look, as the motor is encapsulated by a plastic casing that is designed to look like a dirt bike engine, and the handlebars are complemented by a front nerve plate. The Stacyc, meanwhile, can be customized with 10 different graphic kits that are available in the accessories section of Stacyc's website. Furthermore, Stacyc also offers extended footrests in different colors, a handlebar riser kit for taller kids, and even a motocross-style stand that is scaled down perfectly to match the little bikes. A quick perusal of both company websites also revealed that virtually every important part, including motor parts, are available for both Stacyc models, while nothing is available from SSR online. When it comes to performance, our test riders enjoyed riding both bikes and zipped around non-stop until the batteries were dead. Just watching the kids ride, it was apparent that there was a difference between the two bikes as they accelerated out of corners. While the claimed top speed of the Stacyc in the fastest setting is only 1 mile per hour greater than the SSR at 13, the manner in which the bikes reach their top speed is dramatically different. After noticing the difference on the pump track, we had the kids line up and do some motocross style starts on the bikes, and the results were, well, you can see for yourself. To make sure it wasn't skill, size, or aggression, we had the kids switch the bikes, and the results were comical. After doing a couple starts on the SSR, our little guy actually looped out the Stacyc because he was accustomed to the slow building speed of the Sprinter. And while we're on the subject of power, the Stacyc has 3 different power settings that can be changed within seconds on the handlebars. The slowest setting is great for first timers, and there are 2 more aggressive settings as your youngster learns. The Sprinter, meanwhile, has 2 settings, but switching between the two requires a screwdriver and a little bit of technical savvy from mom or dad. Perhaps the biggest difference between the two involves the recharge time. While the runtime of each bike depends entirely on the weight, terrain, and riding style of your youngster, getting them back in the saddle and having fun varies greatly between the two. The Stacyc battery can be brought back to full charge in under an hour, while the SSR takes 3 hours to replenish. What's more, Stacyc offers additional batteries for purchase that plug into the remote charger and can be swapped out on the bike in only a few seconds. Well, the SSR battery must be charged in the bike, and as best we can tell, additional batteries are not available for purchase online. When it comes to choosing between the two 16-inch models, we think it's well worth investing the extra $300 on the $849 Stacyc over the $549 SSR Sprinter. When it comes to performance, adjustability, maintenance, and miles per hour, there's simply no comparison.
My name is Uriah Herrera.
Vincent Herrera.
They're pretty cool. They're fast and everything. I like them.
Well, when we run out of battery, we can just put another battery in and keep having fun.
But the other bike, you have to plug it in and wait forever.
The Stacyc. And that's the one I like.
And that's the one I like. You ending up doing a wheelie. Mm. That's how strong it is.
The SSR is slow.
SSR is slow.
There's different feelings.
The SSR, it just, on that track, it just feels weird.